Hi. Good afternoon. We're here at Borden-Hewitt's ranch headquarters, which is about approximately 5 miles south of downtown Chico. This is actually the Borden-Hewitt ranch now, and the bee operation is run out of this place here. We have been here since the sign says in 1960. We have bees here in the springtime. Basically, what's going on here now is ammon pollination, and today the ammons are in full bloom. It's around the 26th of February now, so it's full bloom ammon time. This here is the nonpareil variety that we sell at the farmer's market. It's the sweet variety. It's the thin-shelled variety. It's a variety we get paid the most for. This is the ammons that are also exported the most. These are exported, I mean, all over the world now. Then to our left here is a variety called Butte. That's this one right here. This is the late pollinator. And this one here is just opening up right now. It is a hard shell variety. There's still buds here that are going to be coming out all over this tree here. There's bees all through these trees right now. This is the late variety. These are the ones we're paid actually the least amount of money for, but you gotta have them. They're the late pollinator that pollinates with the nonpareil. Okay, on this particular orchard, it's called a one-to-one planting, which is 50% nonpareils, 25% buttes, and then the early pollinators on the other side of this nonpareil tree. So we'll walk over here in a second. And this here is this is Peerless. This is the variety you'll see in Safeway and Rayleigh's, Alex, and all these different stores in the fall around Thanksgiving and Christmas time. These are the ones where they sell Brazil nuts, pecans, and English walnuts. Well, there's hard shell almonds sitting in there, and this is the Peerless variety here. They bloom first. Nonpareils bloom after that, and then buttes bloom at the end. But this year here, for some unknown reason, and probably due to this cold weather we had just preceding the bloom, everything has opened up all at once. So we have ideal pollination weather. So I think from here now we're going to march down to where Victor is. My brother's down here at the beehives. Okay, let's go down the other side then. Okay, we're here's the beehives now, so Victor's going to start smoking them. We don't recommend you run out and start opening up beehives, because what we're doing here is really a technical job. You really got to know what you're doing, because you can really get stung pretty bad. So we're actually used to the bee stings. I normally don't wear a lot of protective gear. We get stung probably 50 to 60 times a day when we're working bees. Okay, Victor, let's take the lid off of that one and see what's going on here. First thing you always want to do is take the lid off, and then he's going to set the lid by the hive there. You never want to stand in front of the beehives, because that's where the bees right now, they're flying out in the trees, and they're coming and going. So basically what he's going to try to do is pull out some bee frames here. He's going to start here on the outside. You always want to start on the outside, because the queen bee, you don't want to kill the queen bee, so you're always looking to see the queen bee. Let's see, show them that frame. That's what this looks like. There's just a few bees running around. Normally this is where the honey's at, but right there, there's hardly anything in those cells right now at all. Okay, then as you work across the hive, we normally don't like to set, if you get one out, we try to put one back. They want to be put back in the same sequence that they're in. Now this here frame has uncapped honey. They're starting to make bloom honey. I'm going to stand out. Let's walk back to your Richards a little bit. This is almond honey here. It looks like water in there. And you turn it over. Now there's none on that side. They tend to make honey in the top box of these bee boxes. Let's see. Okay, we'll put that one back.
Really got a lot of pollen on there.
Okay, now we're getting into something serious here. Now we're getting towards the middle of the hive. And I'm going to reach behind me here and get a stick out of the tree. Get a stick here. I think I'm going to stand over here to this way here. We'll kind of get over here. How about right there for light? Okay, and the bee pollen is right in there. There's your bee pollen. They're collecting off the trees right there. It's all that yellow material there. We have local bee pollen for sale at the farmer's market. This is where they always put pollen in the middle, and always they keep honey up on top. So this here is all almond honey they're making here right now. So that's honey there. The bees are all real gentle. We're raising Italian bees, so they're relatively gentle. Okay, then, there's honey now. So what do we got? What'd you find now? Oh, you found brood now.
Got brood?
Okay, smoke the fronts of these other hives here for a second. Yep, that one. Let me stand back here a second. I think I'll stand over here. Let's go over here a little way. Okay, now we'll be right here. This is the brood. And this is actually where the bees come out. Now this is the honey. There's your bee pollen right in there. And these bees here are, bust off a little chunk of this stick again. But the actual bees are hid underneath these cells. They're right there. That's just a little grub in there. Now he's going to be going through that hive a little bit further, and we'll get a chance to see him. We'll flip this around. He's still looking for the queen. Okay, there it is on that side. So these takes from the egg to the, when they hatch out, 21 days. As you can notice, they're making honey today, so they're really fairly gentle. Okay, we'll march back over here to the beehive. Let him keep going through the beehive. Okay, he's still looking for... We're actually looking for the queen. Queen, did you find any eggs there?
No, there's eggs all over.
Okay, let me see that one. We'll go over here and look at that one.
A little more smoke on that one.
Okay, we'll go back over here in the sunlight and see if we can't see a little bit better here. Okay, this one here's got eggs in it, which is going to be really difficult to see. But I'm going to try to open these cells up a little bit so we might be able to see an egg there. I think there's an egg in the bottom of that hole there. But what there is, that's actually... Okay, he's got the queen over there too. So they tend to lay in the center of the frame. Their stores are always up above. So we'll flip this over real quick, Mike. And over on this side, they're starting to come up from the egg to when they're capped off and hatch out. It's 21 days. So there's all different stages of bees in these things now. Okay, you found the queen over there, so we're going to dash right back over here to the beehives. And, okay, here he's got the queen. We'll come on back over here to our favorite little looking spot. And we'll take a look at the queen here. Okay, there. How's that for light, I think? There we go. Okay, you see it there, Richard? That's an Italian queen bee there.
I don't see him.
You don't see him. She's right there. And they always try to be elusive. They're a little camera shy, so they tend to want to try to hide. And they'll hide in little nicks and crannies. This one here is trying to hide underneath the bees there. She's a nice looking queen. She's a good, fertile queen. Okay. So are we gonna go? Nice. Okay, we're gonna go put this one back, and we're gonna go look at another beehive here.
There's a few queen cells there on that one too.
Yeah, this one, they tend to raise a lot of what we call false stuff, and this is from last year right here. This is where they're trying to swarm last year. Something was going on. I'm not sure what. But you can actually grab these queens, and I'll try to do this without killing. With your hands. You come around here and you can actually put that queen right there on the frames and she'll go away. Okay, you gotta give us a little more smoke here. So we're off to another beehive, and the big thing is you always want to block your entrances. So this one here's flying out. This is a real ripping hive here. He's got about a lot more material here. So what basically we're looking at, here's brood. They normally have honey in the top box, but this time of year, turn it so they can see. They have actually cap brood. We can go into this cap brood, and I'll try my glass on that so I can see a little bit better. But they tend to fill in these areas. Right under here, there should be a bee. And there's a bee in there. He can't come out yet, but we'll try to find one here that's just coming out. We'll look right in. There's one there. Not quite far enough along. The bees will fix all this up when I get done here. I don't see.
I don't see
what I'm looking for yet. Okay. Let's go. We'll keep looking here. Most of these hives have 9 frames in the top. And we'll keep looking until we see what we want to see here. It's the same story. This is overwintered honey up in this area here. This is alfalfa. Then the bee pollen ring is coming here. And then there should be bees hatching out here. We'll keep looking at these frames. Okay, well, there's a little smoke pollen standing here. A bee smoker makes take up honey. So this is another frame just starting out. And then the queen could be running around in there, not no problem. Basically it's more overwintered honey. The bee pollen's right in here. And they're starting to raise a few drones here. Well, if they're starting to raise drones, they're starting to make quite a bit of honey here in the local area. Drones come last. They're actually takes 28 days for those to hatch out. There's a few drones. This is interesting here. Okay, we've got drones here, right here, that they've raised. Those are fairly young. They're about halfway out. There, we'll flip the frame over and look at the other side. They'll raise drones. These tall ones are drones. These are male bees. The male bees will fly out to mate with virgin queens when we start raising queen bees here. This hive here is moving right along too. We've been feeding these. We get down to the bottom of these hives, we'll show you the. This is the same thing here, overwintered honey. This is worker brood here, capped off, and on the bottom of those will always be eggs. These hives are really moving. Let's see, we'll look at one more frame. I guess we're going to try to look for the queen on this one too. We're basically raised Italian queens. This is getting towards the end of the hive. So there's honey here, a lot of pollen here, and there's just a few eggs here. If you get out towards the edges, they tend to store honey. So here's your overwintered honey, and then the bee pollen ring, and then the brood is in the middle. Okay, pull that next one too, just while you're there. Okay, this one here is, this is just honey. So you get towards the edges, they always have their food store. This is all, and they run low, they go right to there. They're trying to make honey in the almonds right now. There's a whole slab there. We'll get down one more shot of smoke. And then that last frame
just got all honey.
It's got honey. Okay, let's move on to one more here. Where was one of those? The lid. I just want to put the lid back. And next, this which one? The corner one here. The minute you open these things up, you give them a little shot of smoke. That cools them down. And you can see they kind of buzz a little bit. I think we're going to do the same drill here. I'll try to. We've been pulling some frames of brood out of here to fix other hives. It's called the Robinette effect. You can take combs of brood and take them to other hives. We have some smaller hives over here across the drive, which we'll be looking at in a little bit. These are standard 10-frame hives. These are the hives we make all our honey with. This is the same thing, the old overwintered honey up here. And the bees are coming on right there on the bottom. Okay, going across here a little bit further. Okay, they're trying already to swarm. Here's a queen cell right there. So they're trying that. And then this is the new style wax. And everything now is plastic. Plastic cells. Plastic cell. These farming areas of beehive back here. There's a backhoe going by right now. This is the same thing. Bee pollen. Here's almond pollen right there. It's all that green. Almond pollen's right there. It's all green. They're really, from last Thursday and Friday to today, they've really been doing it. The weather's been absolutely ideal. There's a newer frame. The bees are really gentle today. When they're making honey, they're not too mean. So we keep moving across there. This is the same thing. More capped off brood. And he found the queen again.
Queen's right there.
Another yellow queen there. Yellow bees build up quicker than dark bees. They're basically Italian and Carnolian, and then the spinoffs are Russians and some of these other things we'll be showing you here in just a minute.
I don't have a good eye. I can't see. Where's the queen?
Right there.
Right there.
Oh, okay.
They're unmarked. We don't mark our queens, so all the queens we raised here are. So this one here is also trying to raise the queen cells. They really must be making a lot of honey to raise queen cells right now. Okay, so let's. Yeah, there's another cell here.
Jeez.
They're really doing all kinds of things. That'll stop when the morning boom stops. Okay. Okay, so looking at all these frames. Let's try to splash a frame. Let's see what's going on. There's a technique that beekeepers use to tell if they're making honey, and that's just by hitting the frame down. Just the honey's actually dripping out of the frames there, so they're doing really well. One of the big things, yeah, see the honey's really pouring out of the frame today. You got to be really careful. Yeah, you really got to be careful when you do that, because if you don't see the queen, you end up throwing the queen on the ground. So he's going to push the frames across with his hive tool, and then we're going to reinsert the frames, and then we will go to another part of the ship. Okay, we'll be off for a second. We're going to march over to where we have our breeding queens. Right in this area here, we have actually the queens that we're going to be grafting larvae off of here in the next few days. We haven't started it yet. But we're going to, this here happens to be a Russian breeder queen. The United States government got busy and tried to find hives that are of good breeding stock. So we got involved in this breeding program with the federal government. And it's through a specific beekeeper who's in Fallbrook, California. But in this hive is a queen that supposedly resistant to the varroa mite and the throat mite. So these bees, as you can see, are really dark. They're really black. They tend to really store a lot of honey, so their combs have really got a lot of honey in them. So we'll keep looking for the queen. We also have inside feeders here. We have a trough in here. We've got a lot of wax in them. We fill those up and chin when we get to it. And then we will look at another one here.
So this is an important queen here.
Yeah, this is an important queen. This queen cost us $200. You'll find it here in just a second. These bees are relatively gentle. These came from the Ukraine. So we'll get one more smoke here. And then we're still looking for the queen. There's the brood and the honey, just like in these other hives. Oh, these bees are black. And they're actually a black bee. They tend to be a little more conservative on brood rearing. They don't store as much pollen or honey, so we will see. We'll keep going through here. Let's see what we've got here. And we'll go with that one there. And we'll look there. And there it is. Okay, it's that queen right there. It's got the blue dot. Okay, Richard, home in on that one. It's right there. It had a number on it. It had a number 86, but the bees have worn it off. Pretty much wore it off. So that queen there is hustling right along. So we'll put that frame back. These bees are black. They're really relatively conservative.
Is there much difference in the gentleness of the bees?
These are about as gentle as they get. As you notice, I'm not wearing any suit right now. If they were mean, they'd be stinging you, but they're not. So let's go on to this is a Russian. Okay, let's move on to a yellow one right here. We'll go to a yellow one right here. Let's try this yellow one right here. Let's see what. These bees are called survivor bees, too. These bees, we've been doing a lot to them. We've had them sitting here all summer. There's not a lot going on here at the ranch in the summertime. We have some garden growing and one thing or another, but we try to let these things kind of go on their own to see if they'll actually make it. And these are doing relatively well. There's the same thing, pollen ring, brood in the middle.
So you take a bunch of your bees over to Nevada, but the ones that you leave here are your breeding bees?
Yeah, the breeding bees we leave here to really let them kind of sort themselves out during the summer to see if they will actually survive. These bees never get any treatments or anything, so they're kind of on
their own. Right there.
They're kind of on their own. That's a nice one there. That's a yellow one right there.
trying to hide, put the frame over the trim. Yeah, she wants to hide. There she is on the end, she's on your right hand. They really like to get away, you know. They're camera shy. That one is, she's on your hand now. Oh, she's right there. They look behind the grooves of the frames. They know these frames by their, what they're really thin and all that, so they're experts at hiding. And there you go. She's just running all over the place. Hey. So that's about the extent of that. And these are single-story box, single-story frames. And he's going to push that one back. We're going to, these are the hides we actually breed off. We're going to go up here to our, we have our five frame nuke boxes. These are the bees that we try to overwinter too. So we'll go up here. This particular queen, if we can find it, has a bad wing and or a bad foot. And it's kind of interesting to how nature tries to help itself out. So pulling this frame out. These are really tight. These only consist of four frames and and an inside feeder. Of course, these have lots of honey in them. These were wintered in, or summered in Nevada. And some, in fact, these are actually summered in Chico. We had a few left in Chico, yeah. So this, they're relatively, they're just coming on pretty good now. They tend to winter a little bit weaker. But when the bees decide to take off, they start taking off. We're looking for the queen there, and we still don't see her. Oh, she's on that one right here. Then we'll go over there. We'll pull that one out. And then we'll put that right there. And we need to put that over. And that'll be right there somewhere. They tend to, when they know you're looking for them,
they can hide really easy.
They can hide, and you're almost looking right at them and not see them. They go back around on that one. You always want to work over the beehive, so like right now, see if on the other side, and if the side should drop off, and they will drop off. You try to get away, so they'll try to drop off. So let's see, let's go over here. This one here is not, we're not going to be able to find it. This one probably
she might be lame, but she got away.
Yeah, she did. She's definitely not boxed this. She's probably in the bottom of the box. Okay, well, we're disappointed not finding that one.
But she's a good queen,
yeah,
even though she's lame.
Yeah, she's a good queen. Let's jump next door here. And we tend to set these things off two by two. We'll look at one more here. We've got to rush off. Let's look at this one, Richard, and we'll head on about bed.
So what is the purpose here of having smaller hives?
These are actually the hives we try queens out in. We have different corrals running to see if these are good or not. We kind of, this is how you test out a Russian queen, or test out a Yugoslavian, or all these different breeds of bees. And we run these
there it is right there.
We run these in the summertime. See, that one's right there. That's a nice one there. That's a yellow there. That's a pure red. That's a good queen to grab off of there. We'll probably end up putting these in 10-frame boxes here next few days and let them expand out. But one or two more frames there. Let me hang on to that one while you're
talking about grafting, and it's not like grafting fruit trees.
No, it's actually a transfer of larvae into like a little cup, like a thimble. So these got a good brood pattern here.
Real good brood pattern.
They're already taken off now. They're doing well. That's a good one. There's about 5,000 holes in one side of a bee frame. That there probably has probably 3,500 bees on both sides of that frame ready to come out. So here in about a week or 10 days, these things will really be full. I mean, they're really starting to crank. There's probably, probably the next 2 weeks will hatch out, probably 15,000 bees. So when those bees come out, this is the size of the rest of these packed.
So of course then nature doing its thing, and they'll try to swarm. There's actually a cell right there that's nesting to it. There's, that was a queen cell we put in this hive, and then that was actually a queen bee hatched out, and that's about major with the drone. It's actually queen prices right here. We'll pull all those off when we do our transfer work. We can take all those off. They're made out of plastic. We keep recycling them. So there's quite a few of them. I can do one more frame. And then we'll go.
There's that a lot weird. Of pollen.
A lot of pollen. They're really collecting the pollen. These long arrows we're getting right now, they're really taking off. They're doing a good job pollinating the trees right now. Okay. So let's put this, let's see what happened to this queen. I hope it didn't fall off on the ground or should have it away from the beehive. Victor's going to probably look for this queen when we get this one around here. Let's see. Try to see if it's
right there.
That's right. Here, you just come up behind them, grab them by the wings. And oops, okay. Then you just set her right down in there. Okay, as you can see, there's a lot to this business. This business entails, there's about 7 or 8 of us working on this project right now. We haul bees in the almond orchards, and from here we go to the prunes in the Yuba City area, and then from there we go to some holding areas out here in the foothills, and then from there we go over to Nevada and Utah. So we're moving these bees all around all the time. And with the pressure of varroa and all these other bugs, this is the purpose of these hives here, to try to fill in some of the weaker hives in the field. So,
are most beekeepers doing stuff like that, trying to find some resistant varieties?
In this area here, we're in the queen breeding area right now, and there's a lot of guys trying different bees right now. We're trying them. Conan's over here across the river trying them.
Because that's been those mites were big.
Oh, they're a big problem. They're really probably the biggest thing that's hurting us right now. So we're really interested in, trying to take care of the problem. So it's all in. We figure in breeding now. If you got it's like in cattle and other things. It's in the breeding stock. If you got the right type of breeding stock, you're going to be resistant to all these bugs. So that's what we're looking for now. We've been searching here for the last almost 10 years now for the ideal bee, and you gotta have a bee that's gentle, you can't have a bee that's really mean, so you gotta have something that you can actually work with. Like today I probably got stung, well, we've been doing this video about 10 times, so if these were really mean bees, you get stung a lot, but we're actually right on top of these beehives and they're not doing much at all, so you gotta have something, collect honey and pollen and come back and do the thing without, everybody getting stung. Okay, as you can see, there's a lot to it, and we're looking forward to seeing you in downtown Chico on Saturdays between 7:30 in the morning and 1 o'clock. We're at 2nd and Wall Street. We're there, rain or shine. Thank you very much. We'll see you again.